Welcome to our Christmas Eve service. We are all invited to gather once more to the manger in Bethlehem. The call is for all of us. Whomever you are, come. Whatever you bring, come. No matter your past, come. Jesus said, "Come to me, all you who are weary, and I will give you rest. Rest for your souls." Matthew reminds us that God blesses those who realize their need of Him. For you will be filled and comforted. You will be shown mercy and inherit the earth. You will be called the children of God. For you will see God. Yours is the kingdom of heaven. Come and see what God has done.
Thank you.
Come, Mary. Come, Joseph. Come to Bethlehem. Do not be afraid, for the child Mary carries is from the Holy Spirit. She will have a son, and you are to call him Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins. To the town of David the king, come.
Christmas Day is nearly here, and there is only one candle remaining.
The Christ candle takes center place in the Advent wreath. It represents the light that the Son brought into the world when he was born a little baby, God in the flesh. This is a special time, the moment of transition from prophecy to fulfillment. He came for one purpose: to save us all from sin and we are reminded that he will return one day in glory. Our scripture for this candle is taken from John 1:29, as John the Baptist sees his cousin Jesus coming toward him and says, "Behold, the Lamb of God, which taketh away the sin of the world."
As we light the fifth and final Advent candle, the Christ candle, we are reminded that the entire Christmas season, all the church services, the tree, the beautiful lights, the gifts, the caroling, are all truly meant to do this one thing, to put Jesus at the center of it all. Rejoice, Jesus is here. He came as a baby, humbly born in a stable. He grew up among us, carrying all the burdens that life brings. He taught us to love one another, and he showed us the Father in the life he lived. And then he did what no other man could do. He humbled himself and became obedient to death, even death on a cross. And God gave him the name that is above every name, Jesus.
We anticipate with vibrant hope. We humble ourselves in solemn preparation. We celebrate with exceeding joy. We live in his unfailing love, all in eager expectation for the coming of the Lord Jesus. Repent, Jesus said, for the kingdom of heaven has come near. Let's pray. Jesus, your kingdom is at hand. Let us come with open hearts and receive you and your kingdom anew today. We choose tonight to seek you and your kingdom and rejoice at your appearing. Let us come to the manger and worship the coming King. For the glory of the Father, in your name, amen.
Sinners.
east studied the skies. They saw his star. They knew the signs. They understood the message. Where is he? Where is the newborn King of the Jews? Isn't it interesting that this is the same title Pilate hung on the cross above Jesus 33 years later? We have gifts for him, they said, to mark his birth and his death. We have come to worship him. Wise men indeed.
Helpless.
the invitation to come does not end here. There is still room in the stable for one more, for you and for me. There was no room left at the inn for Mary and Joseph and the baby, but with Jesus, there is always room for more. The promise of salvation is for you and your children, and for all who are far off, come. No longer the babe in the manger, but now the King of Kings and Lord of Lords, he invites us to come.
Fulfill the law and promise.
He saved us. He saved us all. Taking our sin on himself, he even defeated death itself. But tonight, the baby sleeps peacefully. As we light our candles and relive that first Christmas night, we're invited once more to draw near to Jesus, our Savior and Lord. Just as you are, come.
For joining us on our Christmas Eve service. Just a couple quick, really quick housekeeping things before we close. Pastor John Weiler will be here on Sunday morning. And if you came tonight and you normally don't come to church, we would love to have you come back on Sunday morning. Our service is at 10:30. So let's close in prayer. God, thank you for this night. Thank you for every word that we sung and everything that we have done to glorify you. Thank you for the birth of Jesus. Thank you for sending him to us. And thank you for everyone gathered in this room tonight to adore you and glorify you. I thank you for all you've done and for all the families that you have here and all the love that is in this room right now. I pray all these things in Jesus' name. Amen. I'm just going to close with this. May you be filled with the wonder of Mary, the obedience of Joseph, the joy of the angels, the eagerness of the shepherds, the determination of the Magi, and the peace of the Christ child. And may the Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit bless you now and forever. Merry Christmas.